Hi, thanks so much for coming through to this video. It's really appreciated. This is a full-length version of a soft pastel painting that I did only yesterday, finished today. So basically, as you can see from the drawing, this is going to be a picture of a man holding a surfboard walking along the seafront. It's quite semi-abstract. There's going to be lots of lovely pastel colours in there. Now, to start off with here, I am using the pan pastels because for a first layer, just for getting down and blocking in the colour, they don't take up too much of the tooth of the paper. So I know for sure I'm going to be able to layer up afterwards. And the good thing about pan pastels, you can see my bit of paper there, is that you can mix colours together really nicely. So I'm trying there to create this really nice aquary tealy colour up in the sky. As I say, it's semi-abstract, so take the colours with a pinch of salt. It's not going to be completely lifelike. It will look like what it's meant to look like, but it's going to have lots of colours in there. So here I am just trying to go with using the soft pastel applicator. I'm just trying to basically go in the flow of where the sky is kind of sweeping. It's going to be a sunset. And here I do make a mistake and I'm blending the colours in so much they're muddying. So I come back and sort that out later on. But to just get some colour down to start with is kind of the key here. As long as you've got something to build your colours up from, it's good to just have that background colour. So I'm going to leave you to watch the rest. I won't bore you with this. I don't put music on with these full-length ones because I think if you're going to watch it and you're going to maybe try and paint along, then you can put your own music on, but you can hear when I come in and out and do the voiceovers. So I start on the sky and I basically work my way down. I leave the man and the surfboard out till the end because I use the soft pastel pencils for that, and I have Derwent and Carbothello for those. I absolutely love the Derwent. They sharpen really well with a swordfish sharpener. So I can recommend that completely. So I'll leave you to it, guys. As you can see, there is one layer down now, and I have moved on from the pan pastels onto my pastel sticks. These are half sticks, they're Rembrandts, they are absolutely lovely, they're not too soft, so they don't take up all of the tooth of the paper, but they're not too hard that they're scratching the paper. They're a really nice mid-ground, and I really feel that these will be the best for me for how I like to work. I do lots of layers, so I don't want the really soft pastels filling up the paper too quickly. And I'm just playing around really, trying to get the colours that I want. Yes, I do mix with my fingers, I just find it easier. It's that tactile kind of thing. It's not for everybody, I get that, but I just love to just get in there. So again, I'm laying her up. I am looking at a digital photo that I created using AI prompts. So I had something to go by. I'm not particularly good at imagining pictures in my head. So please don't think that that's something I have done here. I have very carefully created a prompt. Took me quite a long time to get the image that I wanted, but you know, AI is here to stay, so let's embrace it and let's use it where we can. And it really helps put what's in my imagination into a picture so that I can then go from there and create it myself with the medium that I choose. Here obviously I'm using soft pastels, but I do vary. Sometimes it's acrylics, watercolors, colored pencil, markers, so I like to dot around. I'm not one for just sticking to one thing. I mean, it does mean I'm not necessarily a complete expert at all of them, but I'm okay with that. I have a decent amount of knowledge of each now, and I'm okay with that. I don't need to be a super expert at one medium, as long as I enjoy the process. And that's what I want you to get from these videos that I do. I want you to enjoy the process. So enough waffling. I am just trying out the different colours, trying not to press too hard because I don't want to fill in the paper. I want to keep layering. So I am following the picture, but I'm also kind of, it's just a guide. I'm also kind of going with how I'm feeling at the moment and what looks right and what doesn't. I know, and I understand at the moment, you're probably looking at and thinking, oh, it's a blurry mess. Please don't worry about that. I always say to myself, it's the ugly stage. It does get better. It's just about layering and layering until you get where you want. So again, I'm going to leave you with this while I use the sticks, and you can just listen to music and watch, or you can obviously follow along. If you do follow along, please remember to stop and start as and when you need to kind of catch up. But yeah, hope you enjoy. So as you'll see now, I've come to the end of using the sticks. Apologies for the picture being on its side. I do sometimes forget the camera's running and I'm in the zone, I'm in the arting zone. Now I'm moving on to pencils because I feel as though I've put enough background colours down now in kind of the tones and shades that I want. And I want to come in and refine it, and I find refining it with my coloured pencils, not my colour pencils, sorry, my soft pencils, my coloured soft pencils, I find that's the easiest way to come in and detail and just refine more carefully, should I say. Because if you're using the sticks or the pan pastels, you're going to be very, very loose with those. And now I can come in and be a bit tighter and a bit more specific about my mark making. So, and I can also pick out of the pencils. I have quite a big set. I can pick out any colours that I may not have necessarily had in the sticks or the pan pastels. I mean, you can mix the pan pastels to an extent, but it's not the easiest. So, yeah, I shall leave you to watch me fill in the pastels. Please don't forget, if you have any questions, guys, just let me know in the comments. Thank you so much for being here. I know if you're watching this, you're probably a member because the full-length ones are in membership. So I appreciate you guys. I hope you enjoy and get something from this. I just wanted to come in here and just a little reminder about values. So although in the background there's that cliff there, I am trying to pick out light, middle and dark areas of the cliff to make it give it some realism. So you'll get a bit more realism by having the three levels that of the three values of color. So I've got a dark, very dark brown, almost black. There's a lighter brown there, and there is kind of a mid brown that we associate with being brown, you know, like the brown bear kind of brown. So I am smudging them in because it kind of gives that nice background. I'm using the soft tool again to do that. So I'm kind of taking away the specific marks that I made, but you'll see that I do come in again. I'm not sure if it's now or later, but I do come in again and try and put them back in. Sorry about using my phone. It's probably one of my children. So that will be the only reason why I'm doing that. They usually interrupt me in the middle of my working day. So yeah, I'll carry on. I'll leave you to it to carry on, just to let you know what my thinking is there with all of those different browns. And even towards the end, I leave some more detailed marks till the very, very end in very dark. I think I use a black in the end. So yeah, and I'm smudging it until I feel happy that I'm ready to leave those strong marks in. I don't want them to stand out too much. And I think it's easier done at the end when you've got the whole picture done. And then you can see where you want to put those really detailed lines in. So I'll leave you again. Okay, it's time to start working on the ocean and really getting those colours right. Working with the ocean, as long as you've got, again, the varying levels of blues, greens in there, and you're going with the flow of the water, so it will look like it's in those striations, those lines going across. So I also come in a bit with some yellow to reflect the sun, and before the end I put some pink in, because that would make sense that they would be reflecting off the sea. But remember, this is kind of semi-abstract, it's not complete realism. It's just something pretty, just something pretty. So, yep, I'm going to work my way down the sea and sand. The final thing I do is the man with the board. And you'll see I struggle with him a bit at the end. I'm not great at drawing people. It's not my favourite thing. So it's trying to get his proportions right. Even though he was behind the board, it's quite tricky. So maybe you can do a better job than me. Okay, everyone. I'll go now and leave you in peace. So now that I've got the main colours down for the sea, I want to really come in with that white and give it some definition and start to make the froth of the sea stand out. And the only really way to do that is with the white half stick, because it's so vibrant still. Even when you've layered and layered with other colours, it will still be really vibrant. And what I notice, because I put too much white down the bottom, there's no darker areas, so I have to go back in, put some dark areas in, and then I feel happy about how much value there is against that dark. It's about having the lights, highlights against the dark. If the dark isn't there, your highlights won't show up. I feel better about the top bit there. And I start to just make those splash marks as well. Again, it's semi-abstract. Don't think I've ever seen a wave that big right by the shore. It looks like it's about to swallow him up. But I kind of just liked it, so I ran with it. Okay, guys, I'm off again. So onto the sand section now, and I'm just making sure I've got the lights and darks in, as I always talk about value, as you all know. It's just making sure that I've got some really dark areas that can then lift the highlights. And I want to make sure it's quite mixed in, because it is the sand. I don't want it to be the most poignant part of the picture. But yeah, so I mix them in. I add some more pinks and blues to the sea edge and things like that. So yeah, all I'm doing there is trying to create some oomph into the sand. And there I'm trying to make it a bit more orangey, a bit more something, a bit more vibrant. It was looking, what I would say, is dead. So yeah, that's what I'm doing. Oh, look, I'm even lightening it now because I thought it was too much. Okay. Okay, so having just kind of finished off the sand, I soon decide it's time to do the man and the surfboard. So that's what the majority of the rest of this will be about now. So I'm mainly using my pencils because I need to get in there and be a bit more accurate about it. I can't be as loose as I have been about the rest. So I come in, first of all, do his top. And I am using, as I say, my reference picture as a guide. However, like, he didn't look right to begin with when I put his legs in. They looked too short for his body, and then his arms looked too long for his body. So it took a bit of fiddling out. And I think what made it more difficult, as I've said before, is him holding that surfboard. But I hope that it came out all right in the end. I don't think it's as good as I could have done it, but you know, all things come with practice, and people is where I'm at. I'm practicing people, the sea and skies and cliffs and things like that. I'm well practiced at, but people, not so much, as you will see. So I'll leave you to watch me finish that bit off. So now that I finally finished off my man there walking along, I decide to come in and just, I don't know, titivate the picture and play around with it until I feel like I'm really happy with it. I'm not really making any major changes because I don't want to ruin what's already there because I'm happy enough with what's already there. But very often if you come away from a picture that you're doing and then come closer, you can see things that you wish you'd have done. So that's what I'm doing here. Okay, hope you enjoy the rest of the video. And I hope if you've had a go at this, that you've enjoyed that. If you have any questions, again, please don't forget to ask in the comments. And thank you for being a member. Much appreciated. Okay, take care, everyone.